because today you're sure of a big surprise. If you go down in the woods today, you better go in disguise.
Nanny took her three grandchildren for the day to go out for a picnic to Avebury. She parked the car, then she got out and got a parking ticket to put in the car as you do. Then she came back and said to the three children, come on, we'll go out. We'll take the picnic and we'll go for a walk. And as we got out, Bethany looked at the car next to me, who's 2 years old, and said, oh, Pooh, Pooh, Pooh. And all over the car was bird poo. All everywhere. It was over the bonnets, over the wheels, over the wing mirror, everywhere. I said, no, that's okay. That's all right. That's on that car. She said, no poo on Nanny's car. I said, no, not on Nanny's car today. So we walked and we went to the parkway and we saw the gate. I went through the gate. And as I went through the gate, Max said, I can see swans. I can see bears. Ellen said, I can see the fairy princess and I see butterflies. And we were in the woods. We were walking around the woods and the fairy princess came over and said, follow me and I'll show you some magic. My kingdom, I have a castle. And Max said, I will give you some of our food if we all have a picnic together. So she said, what you have to do is close your eyes and count to three. Then when you open, you will see. So we closed our eyes. And suddenly we were in the forest. We were in the most beautiful woods with the swans flying, the butterflies, the horses, the bears all sitting around. And we laid out the picnic. Max said, here, we've got hummus for you. We've got some ham sandwiches, some cheese sandwiches, whatever you'd like to have. So the fairy princess ate them. They danced, they played, they did everything. And Bethany said, Nanny's car, Nanny's car. I said, Nanny's car's fine. Nothing will happen to Nanny's car. So we carried on. We had great joy. There was music. The bears then put on their hats because it's Halloween. Then Max said, can we stay here forever, Nanny? I said, no, we can't stay here forever because we have to go home. This is pretend. This is lovely. But we have to come home. And then she looked at her watch and she saw, oh my goodness, we have to rush because you've got to be home for your dinners and you've got to have your baths. So I said, but I don't know where we are. And the fairy princess said, well, this is my kingdom and this is where I've showed you today what it's like to have a bit of magic and a bit of ambition and love. But she said, close your eyes and count to three and you will see. We closed our eyes and we were back in the pathway. And there was the gate, as though nothing had happened. And we walked through the gate towards the car. And Bethany said, no poor Nanny's tar. The end.